Now let us see operators available in Ruby. So first one is Ruby arithmetic operators. We have seen this, but I'll be explaining it once more because those are very important things in programming. Suppose A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 2. So like first one is we can add them. It will give the result. We can minus them, we can multiply them, we can divide A by B, and A modulus will give the remainder. Here it is 1. And we can also see the power of A power of B. 1 to the power of anything is 1. That's why the result here is 1. So this is all about arithmetic. I think you are comfortable with the arithmetic operators. Now let us see comparison operators, Ruby comparison operators. So whenever you are using this, you should have to first, like we have seen some operators in this in if statements, like we can compare it now. A is equal to B. End. Or we can see what A is equal to B. See, in the interactive Ruby, when we are typing A is equal to B, it is giving false because A is 1, B is 2. Suppose we A less than B, it is true. If you want to make any statement always true, you can also write if true. Or if 1, 1 is for true, 0 is for false. Like print A, and see here it is printing the value A. A is equal to 1, we are getting the value. So always A is 1. If you want to make false, if 0, 0 is for false. And A, this is for A is, if A is not equal to true. So what does it returns? It returns 2, because here A is 1, B is 2. It is not equal to, hyphen and is equal to. And we can check A greater than B, false. A less than B, which is true. We can check whether A greater than equal to B, yet either them, if any one of them is true, the statement will get true. A is A greater than or equal to true, it is false. A less than equal to B, equal to B is also always false. If less than is true, it will return true. So that is all about comparison operators. And there is one more operator, Ruby assignment operator. So we have seen like A is equal to 1, B is equal to 2. That is A assignment. And we can also write A plus is equal to 1, which is 2. This is equal to, instead of writing A is equal to A plus 1, we are writing A plus 1 is equal to 1. A plus is equal to, let us say we can write anything, 3. Now the A value is 3. It will add to the A. This is equal to A is equal to A plus 3. This will return 6. We can also write like A plus is equal to the B. B value is 2. It will add to 6. 6 plus 2 is equal to 8. Same thing goes with minus. Minus is equal to B. 6. It is A is equal to A minus B. And same thing goes with the multiplication. And division, modulus, and the power of. All are the same. So when we are telling like is equal to b. This will be actually equal to a is equal to a. Instead of writing a every time here, because we are using simple one, it is easy to type a is equal to a multiplication of b. So when we have like number multiply, suppose this is the name, so instead of again writing this one, we can just add the operator is equal to 1. Like this we can use. There is also a parallel assignments. So what is parallel assignment? So until now what we are doing, we are doing a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2. So instead of that, we can write a comma b is equal to, let us change the values, 3 comma 4. Now a will be 3, b will be 4. So parallelly we can assign the values to multiple variables, or we can also, like here, see a b is equal to bc. We are getting the values from the other variables and assigning to this. So suppose a comma b is equal to 1 comma 1, we will give 1 comma 1, and c comma d is equal to 2 comma 2. Now let us say a comma b is equal to c comma d. Now a value is 2, b value is 2. Like this we can play around once we know they are available. And there are also a bit operator, like this is for AND, this is for OR, this is for XOR, this is for getting the bit to the left, getting the bit to the right. And there are also logical operators like AND, OR, this is also AND, this is OR, this is not. Like, see, we have seen in our previous example, we have written a equal to, when we are comparing, 1 or a equal to 2, or means any one of them true. So instead of this, we can also write here, we can write or. This is also true. So hope you understood. This is for not equal to. Instead of this one, we can also use the word not. That's all. Hope you understood the operators. I will be sending all the operators with the description in the next lecture. You first go through before proceeding to the further sections. So meet you in the next video.